This is a tutorial on how to make Spotify canvases using a free template. You'll be making videos like these that were actually used with this template. They're 3 to 8 second video art pieces that play underneath your song, and they enhance the feelings and emotions of the music that you're sharing. Now, the biggest problem with making these videos is that they need to be 9:16. And currently, iMovie doesn't let you make videos like that. And other software is really expensive. But don't worry, we'll be using Kapwing. It is a free software online. You can add multiple clips, you can add transitions, you can resize, reposition, layer, add color graphics. You just need a login to remove the watermark. To start, click on the link in the description to be taken to the Spotify Canvas Maker. Click Make It. It's already perfectly sized just for you. The first step is to upload your footage. So click over here, Upload, and drag and drop, or click here to open up your files. I've already loaded a bunch, so your files will be saved. So your files will be saved here in Library. Let's pull this one in. Grab these little pull bars on the side and reframe. I can also reposition by clicking and dragging. Now you need to make sure your video is 3 to 8 seconds long. So you have two ways of doing that. You can go to trim right here and then pull this purple layer or blue layer down until it is within 3 to 8 seconds long. This will tell you how long it is. You can also see here, move this whole section by clicking and dragging. The other way to trim your video is to click in your timeline. Go here to timeline and you can drag and pull the ends of this clip to make them shorter. Just make sure you scoot it back to the beginning of the timeline. Your other option is to hit play, see where you want to make a cut, then hit split right here. And then just delete whatever you don't want. Go through and adjust, make sure you have the right moments in your footage. And then a good technique is to copy and paste your footage a few times to make sure that it feels cool and right when it's on loop. Command C, Command V, just play them one after each other. Let's see what that looks like. Oh, whoops. You want to also make sure that you delete your extra copies so that way you don't export a video that's too long. Okay. You can add text by clicking here. If you want to add images or emojis, click this image button and the image tab will search Google for you, and then we have emojis here. Okay, when you're done, click this red export button up here. When you're all done, click download. Now you need to go to Spotify for Artist, click in the music tab, find your song, and upload your canvas. If you click on the link in the corner, you'll see a video from Spotify on how to do this in much more detail. Now stick around for more tips and tricks. There's also really cool stock footage out there. There's bad stock footage, but there's cool stuff. So like this website, Free Synthwave Loop Animations, you can create some pretty cool videos there for you. Another thing to remember is that the bottom portion of your frame might be cut off by graphics that get overlaid by Spotify. So try to avoid putting any important information at the bottom. This isn't a music video. So you don't want to do shots of you singing, because if you're trying to sing along with the music, remember this is a 3 to 8 second loop. Your words will not match up with the rest of your video. If you want to add your song while you're making this, click this audio button up here and you can drag and drop your song. Just make sure to delete it at the end, because if it's really long, then it's going to make your timeline like 3 minutes long. And you know, this piece has to be 3 seconds. The audio is going to get deleted in Spotify. If you want to alter the footage, click adjust. And then you have options to change the opacity. You can change the brightness, contrast, saturation. Here's a cool technique for adding color overlays. This is also a great idea if you're doing multiple videos in an album and you kind of want them all to feel similar. You could use the same color overlay. So click Elements, and I'm going to use a square, make it really big, and then let's see, click on it, and then you can change the fill color. Pinks and oranges and yellows are warmer colors, and blues and greens are colder colors. So let's do like this color pink. I don't want an outline on it. Now let's lower the opacity. Look what that looks like. That's kind of cool. Maybe I'll like even lower it a bit. This is what it looks like without it. You can even just do like the subtlest little bit, and it kind of just like makes it feel a bit nostalgia-y. You could probably do like a more, like maybe that would make it look more sepia toned. And if you wanted to feel like cool, crisp, you could try this. Oh, they're both so fun. Let's try adding in another shot. So if we go into our timeline and then upload, here's another clip that I have. Oh, took me out of the timeline. Now you'd want to make sure it was sized appropriately. In this case it is. Go into the timeline and lay one after the other. You also can shorten it a little bit and make a split here. Great, I think that's still split. Okay, shorten that. Now you'll notice that I had that blue overlay on the first clip and I don't see it here. That's because when you add new video layers, they're going to be stacked on top of each other. So you'll see this video that I added is over that rectangle. So just click on the video and then click down here to send back. Now they're all matching. This is a great way to make multiple clips feel cohesive, either all throughout all of your album or multiple clips in one video. It'll really make them feel like they're unified. Now, if you want to add a transition between these two clips, make sure you select the video clip you want to animate in and then go to animate and then do fade. You could do pop in, slide up, drop in. For this one, I'm just going to do fade because I think it's like a soft video. Let's see. Then you have a few different options for transitions. You can also do a hue rotate, which is pretty cool. Your song that you put so much hard work into deserves a good canvas. So take some time, explore the tool, and make something that you're really, really proud of. And definitely share it with Kapwing because we love seeing the kind of stuff you guys come up with. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I'll see you on my next video.